This is it. Texas Stadium's Parade of Champions, Texas Stadium, Irving, Texas, the greatest card the world has ever seen. Hello, everyone. I'm Mark Lawrence for World Class Championship Wrestling. On this show, it's video time, the world television premiere, Bad Street, USA.
Here we are at Texas Stadium. Back again, Mark Lawrence with you as Chris Adams and Sunshine make their way through the crowd for this outstanding mixed tag main event. Gorgeous Jimmy Garvin and Precious are already in the ring. There you see Sunshine and Chris Adams wearing the outfit that once belonged to Gorgeous Jimmy Garvin. In the meantime, Precious is removing the wild paraphernalia. What is this?
I've heard it one time. I've heard it 10,000 times today that this is the greatest wrestling card of all time. Well, so what if the Von Erichs swept the world titles? So what if there's 50,000 of you here? No card is the greatest wrestling card of the world without Gino Hernandez, the handsome half-breed. Furthermore, I don't know what these two mentally deranged females are doing in a ring. And you call yourself gorgeous. And you washed up punk. Come 2 weeks from now, whichever one of you washed up past bands is champ, San Juan, Puerto Rico, you'll be all mine.
Well, the words of Gino Hernandez making a challenge to the winner of this bout.
Shut up!
Let's go on with the introduction and then elaborate on this in a minute.
As I was about to say, this is a mixed tag team match. First of all, it's one fall, 45-minute time limit. Behind me here, from Florida, Mr. Gorgeous Jimmy Garvin and his partner, Precious. And their opponents, gentlemen Chris Adams. Referee is Bronco Lubitz.
Well, this bout's ready to get underway, and a surprise visitor in Gino Hernandez coming to the ring and saying, so what about Kerry Von Erich winning the world title? And look at Adams tear Garvin's old ring jacket in half with Sunshine. Anyway, Hernandez has made a challenge to the winner of this bout, and we'll have to see what happens with that. In the meantime, it's mixed tag time. The girls are sanctioned and legal. It'll be man on man, female on female. And Sunshine's ready to get started, but Garvin is going to make sure he's in the ring, which will force Adams to start off. Go, ring the bell. Texas Stadium, Irving, Texas, the Parade of Champions. What a card it's been. What a day it is. Bronco Lubitz warning Gorgeous Jimmy Garvin. Down goes Chris Adams. Garvin up. And he will be slammed by Chris Adams. Nearly 50,000 fans watching this, the biggest card ever. We've already seen Kerry Von Erich become the World Heavyweight Champion. Yes, that's right. Say it again. Kerry Von Erich, the new World Heavyweight Champion. Garvin misses. There's the sunset flip down. Watch the leg scissors. There they are. Adams wants to tag out. Can't quite reach Sunshine. Garvin won't let him. And it'll be interesting to see if Garvin tries to protect Precious by staying in the ring. When Adams tags out, Precious has to come in whether she likes it or not. And chanting, go Chris, go. There's a tight shot of the headlock by Gorgeous Jimmy Garvin. Over goes Garvin to the rope. There's Adams to the rope. Back double clothesline. Double clothesline, and both men went down. Bronco Lubitz to the count. Both men coming back to their feet. There's the super kick. And here's the tag this crowd wanted to see. Precious doesn't want in. Look at her over there. She wants no part, but Sunshine puts her into the hard way. Sunshine on Precious. Oh, look at Precious catapulted into the corner. And it's scratching and clawing and slapping. Precious over to tag Garvin, who really is in no position to come in. Here's the vertical suplex, and in again comes Gorgeous Jimmy Garvin. Here's a pin and just a count of two. Body slam. Here's a pin by Adams. The mixed tag bout. Into the ropes. Up and into the corner. Garvin dropping Chris Adams. Here's Sunshine in. She is dying for a piece of the action. She steps through the ropes as Garvin has Adams face down. Corner and Adams is in bad shape. His head is bleeding. Adams right there on top of him. What is this going to be? Not in a pile driver, I hope. No. Instead, Adams throws Garvin over. And here comes Sunshine again at Precious. Hey, Garvin tripped her. Garvin tripped her, and that allows Precious to really get it. Sunshine. Here's Adams back in now to get rid of Garvin, but that really opened the door for Precious. Adams has been thrown out. It's Garvin and Precious on poor Sunshine. And Precious begins to slap away at Sunshine. It's gotten out of hand. Precious still on Sunshine. Sunshine on her feet now. Here's a sunset put by Adams. And the count of three. And this bout is over. Adams out of nowhere for the victory. Here's Ralph Fuller.
The winner, gentlemen, Chris Adams and Sunshine.
All right. Chris Adams and Sunshine are victorious. But look out. Precious has gotten the purse. And it isn't over yet. Well, I guess it is. Precious got her shots in, and she and Garvin are leaving. Sunshine is down. Again, Adams and Sunshine are winners in this bout. There you see Gorgeous Jimmy Garvin being ushered out through the crowd as 50,000 have looked on, and Sunshine is going after her. Sunshine is going after her. Garvin and Precious don't know she's coming, and there they go. Yes, indeed, it isn't over yet. Adams over there now, and Precious and Garvin run for their life up the tunnel. What about? It went all the way back to the tunnel. We'll be back for some closing comments in just a minute.
This event, one fall, 30-minute time limit. First of all, on my left, from Louisiana, weighing 245 pounds, Hacksaw Butch Reed.
Yeah, baby, it's a real man here.
And his opponent, from Los Angeles, a California surfer weighing 240 pounds, Chick Donovan. Your referee is Bronco Lubitsch.
Bronco Lubitsch to officiate this event as Ralph Pulley gives us the introduction. I'm Mark Lawrence here at Texas Stadium's Parade of Champions on World Class Championship Wrestling as Hacksaw Butch Reed. A tremendous star with an unbelievable physique goes against Chick Donovan of much the same category. Both these guys have upper torsos that are enough to block a fast-moving train. Hacksaw Butch Reed, one of the more vocal members of the wrestling corps around the world. And he's giving Donovan a few words already. Texas Stadium's Parade of Champions is taking place this afternoon in front of the largest crowd ever to see professional wrestling anywhere, bar none. And this crowd is seeing an outstanding card, and you're seeing it all right here. Hacksaw Reed parading around in front of this crowd.
You want to try that again, man? You want to try that again?
Having plenty to say to Chick Donovan. There's the referee's stance that doesn't go anywhere. Looks like Donovan may have tried to pick him up. There's a dropkick surprise. Bear trap takedown and Donovan. All of a sudden in the driver's seat looking for a handle, finds one around the neck.
No.
The reverse chin lock with Hacksaw Reed down. We've got a real treat for you coming up as we'll have some music for you from a couple of stars. The World Heavyweight Championship bout is coming up for you. The mixed tag bout. So we're just getting started. There you see the hole in the roof here at Texas Stadium, home of the Dallas Cowboys and SMU Mustang. Underneath the elbow, here's an arm drag. As Donovan hooked Reed, now pulls him over with a hip. Leg scissors quickly. And both men come free. There's a side headlock by Chick Donovan. This is a one fall bout, 30 minute time limit. A warm afternoon here in Irving, Texas. Temperature, oh, I guess about 90 degrees. It's been a sunny day. Most of the seating area in shade now. A test of strength here. Both men trying to pull the other one down. Hacksaw Reed with a hair. There's a drive by Hacksaw Reed. Boy, these guys have tremendous builds. And this is a fabulous bout. To the floor, look out. Donovan to the feet of Miss Texas, who's sitting at ringside. Dana Rogers with Lee Don Magnus.
Hello, sucker.
And Hacksaw Reed kicking Donovan away. Here's Donovan back to the apron, and he's knocked away by Hacksaw Reed. Here's Donovan knocking Hacksaw Reed away. There's a drive by Chick, another one from the right. From the ropes, Reed runs into Donovan. Takes him across with the arm. There's the kick, and Donovan goes down after having all the momentum for just a moment. Up in the air, what is this going to be? An airplane slam? Spin? No! Hacksaw Reed just dropped it. Just flat dropped it. And he is dancing. Flashes in with that shoulder splash. Here's a pin. Three. This bout is over. Hacksaw Reed, a winner. Here's Ralph Puller.
The winner is Hacksaw Butch Reed.
Hacksaw Butch Reed, a winner. And we'll be back for a special treat when World Class Championship Wrestling returns in just a moment. Mark Durant's here at Texas Stadium in Irving, where 50,000 fans are watching the great Kabuki enter the ring behind his world-renowned manager, Gary Hart. The great Kabuki, dressed in his melting pots of sin wardrobe, the place where he grew up, where he learned to live the way he does for purposes of survival. And it's time for this bout to get underway. Here's Ralph Puller.
This event, one fall, 30-minute time limit. First of all, on my right, from Singapore, the greatest martial arts expert in the world, the great Kabuki. And his manager, Gary Hart. And their challengers, first of all, weighing 330 pounds from Uganda, Kamala, the Ugandan giant. And his manager, Skandar Akbar. Your referee is Bronco Lubitsch.
Okay, Bronco Lubitsch will do his best to officiate this bout. I am reluctant to say two men in this bout because they are really beasts, animals. Kamala, the Uganda giant, you know about him. From the jungles of Uganda, cannibalistic instincts difficult to communicate with. The great Kabuki from Singapore grew up in an area of that city known as the melting pots of sin, where you had to be a killer in order to survive. The greatest martial arts expert the world has ever seen, as you see him demonstrating his abilities in front of this jam-packed Texas stadium in Irving. The largest crowd ever to see professional wrestling anywhere in the world, without a doubt, is here for this great card. The greatest card the world has ever seen, making history. Gary Hart removing the nunchucks. You see them there in his hand. Gary Hart, one of the most sinister managers in all of sports. There's Kabuki removing the mask. And underneath the mask, you will find a second mask, which is the hair. And under that, yet a third mask, which is the painted face, covering the scars of the early childhood period and adolescence, when he was not much more than an animal for survival in that melting pot of sin. There's the great Kabuki. There's Gary Hart, the man who led this man out of Singapore and into a career here in North America as one of the most deadly beasts ever to come in the ring. And there's his opponent, Kamala, the Ugandan giant. Deadly, cannibalistic, and unpredictable. We know Kamala has never before seen the likes of this type of creature. The same thing goes for Kabuki. There's no telling what may happen. And there's that green mist that we've seen before. It's blinded Fritz Von Erich in one eye here a couple of years ago. It's blinded opponents. We don't know what it is, but whatever it is, it's dangerous. Everyone has stood clear, and we're ready to get this bout underway. World-class championship wrestling coming to you from Texas Stadium in Irving, Texas. As close to 50,000 fans are here, the biggest crowd ever to see professional wrestling. Kamala pounding the chest, Kabuki in the background. Have you ever seen a bout like this before? Keep your eye on the managers, Gary Hart and General Akbar at ringside. Hart already lurking around. Ralph Pulley again with us this week, a part of world-class championship wrestling from the stadium. Notice how each opponent carefully sizing up the other, realizing the impending danger that lurks around the next corner. Photographers around the ring from all over the world. Kamala with the first chops on Kabuki. Kabuki being choked, spitting the green mist into the air, and Kamala throws him away. Kabuki much smaller in size, but with his martial arts capabilities, these two men are probably equal. Photographers from all over the world, news, sports, wrestling publications, newspapers. Hard to handle the media in for this card. Kabuki with that reverse thrust kick. Kabuki again, this time to the chin. The great Kabuki. The fingers deformed and bent. A warm afternoon temperature, around 90 degrees. And this crowd really seeing the action, and Gary Hart now. And Akbar may be having problems. Also Friday, Kamala's valet. There's Friday, there's Akbar. And there are the combatants back in the ring. There's a drive by Kamala, the Uganda Giant, and now a bear hug as Kabuki off his feet. Don't forget, here on this show, you'll be seeing the World Heavyweight Championship. And that'll be for you coming up. Kabuki's still in the midst of that bear hug by Kamala. All right. Here's Kamala lifted into the, or rather Kabuki lifted into the air by Kamala, the Ugandan giant. Akbar showing his approval at ringside as you see the painted face of the great Kabuki. There's Gary Hart sizing up this bout in this tremendous crowd. Kabuki chops across the head with both sides of each hand. There's a drive by Kamala. Gary Hart, one of the few, if not the only, individual who can communicate with Kabuki. Bronco Lubich officiating this event as Kamala has a nerve clasp on the great Kabuki, who falls to his back. Here's the count of just two. This is just one of the world's greatest cards that this crowd is enjoying here. And we're glad to bring you this bout between Kamala the Uganda Giant and the great Kabuki. You can hear the sounds from the rings, the breathing, the snorting, the growling. Gary Hart lurking around there around Akbar. And there you see Akbar with Hart in front of him. And now Hart returning to his position. Kamala pulling the hair. And down goes Kabuki. Kamala with that nerve clasp there, you can see it. Kabuki can explode at any moment. Look at that face. Great work by our crew. You are even closer than ringside. Gary Hart communicating with Kabuki in some foreign tongue. Kabuki raising the hand and he chops that wrist away. Reverse thrust kick. And Kamala fall. Kamala over there in the ropes, Kabuki. Kamala comes away. There's Kabuki moving his way so very slowly. There's a chop. Friday climbing to the ring and shouting at the referee. Gary Hart has removed his coat and is moving around the ring. Kabuki charges, or Kamala rather charges. Kabuki gets a foot up. Kamala falls. Akbar, look out. Hart is chasing Akbar, and Gary Hart nails Friday. Akbar is in the ring. It's broken loose. I was afraid of this. Gary Hart in the ring now. Hart nails Kamala and comes after Akbar. Ring the bell. Gary Hart stomping. General Akbar, the boss of Devastation Incorporated. Hart against Akbar. Kamala back against Kabuki. And there's no stopping it. Here's David Manning running from the back. Hart choking Akbar. And Kamala and Kabuki are still going at it. Kabuki kicking Kamala away. Someone will need to restrain Hart. He's going in after Kamala. Kicking him in the face. And both men will be disqualified, I believe. Both beats, if you please, have been disqualified. It's been a wild bout. I'm Mark Lawrence. Hope you enjoyed it from Texas Stadium. We are here at Texas Stadium where the world-renowned Junkyard Dog is making his way to the ring. As General Akbar waits in the ring, trying to keep up with the unpredictable and dangerous missing link. There he is with the choker chain. Akbar out there, the missing link, and look out, it may break out here on the floor before we even have a chance to get in the ring with it. The dog making his way to the ring. The missing link has a chair in hand. The dog is dancing and howling. The fans cheer, and Akbar moves back in the ring. And here comes the missing link. Junkyard Dog removing that chain and collar. Hailing, of course, from Louisiana. And for this main event on this Parade of Champions card. Here's Ralph Pulley.
And his opponent from Louisiana, weighing 245 pounds, the Junkyard Dog. And again, from lands unknown, weighing 245 pounds, General Akbar's the missing link.
Okay, Ralph Pulley making the introduction. Glad to have him a part of world-class championship wrestling this afternoon from Texas Stadium in Irving. This is going to be an outstanding bout as these two unpredictable and dangerous men get at each other. Look out! The missing link darts across the ring, and here we go, ring the bell. The missing link already coming to the apron. And he's right back in against the Junkyard Dog. The link out to the floor, picking up chairs. And Freddie Sinclair, the referee, caught it in midair. Now the Junkyard Dog wants it and smashes it over the head of the missing link. Here we go. It didn't take long, did it? And the missing link disappears out there again. This is what we've been talking about, the Parade of Champions. Here's the missing link back in. Listen to the crowd response as the Junkyard Dog means all business. There's a headbutt. He Here's the dog against the ropes against the missing link. General Akbar, the boss of Devastation Incorporated, has assembled one of the most awesome wrestling teams that one can imagine. The likes of the Super Destroyers, Kamala, the Ugandan Giant, and this man, the missing link. We know so little about him, and we know nothing of what to expect. There's a hit in the turnbuckle where the missing link seems to be saying that, that doesn't mean much. The missing link goes to the corner, pounds that head into the turnbuckle. There's the dog, he's ready to bite. Folks, this is taking place right now and in front of the biggest crowd ever to see professional wrestling in person. The headbutts have the missing link in the corner. The dog won't give him an inch. There's a drive by the dog. Charges, but the missing link ducks out from under and the chin goes into the turnbuckle. Fans enjoying a bright sunny afternoon at Texas Stadium, temperature in the low 90s. Here's the missing link climbing from the center turnbuckle, dives, and the missing link hits nothing but ring as the junkyard dog got out of the way. Here's a pin. No, Akbar crawls up and distracts the dog, and the dog goes over and nails Akbar, but look out, here's the missing link from behind. The link turns, goes to the rope, spins, comes off with that diving head splash. Here's a pin, one, Akbar's got the foot free. There's the bell, and the missing link will be a winner here while Akbar held the foot. The missing link winds up winning this event, although you saw what happened. Here's Ralph Pulley.
The winner is the missing link.
So the missing link. Well, wait, what's happening? Bronco Lubitsch here. An argument ensuing. The dog in the link at it again, and let's see what happened. The junkyard dog will be awarded this bout in a decision reversal by Bronco Lubitsch, who saw what happened evidently on the back. And the missing link will not win this bout, as the bout will go to the junkyard dog. The missing link going bananas at ringside. Akbar is upset, but that may be all there is to it, as the bout has been given to the junkyard dog after the outside interference. We'll be back for the American Tag Team Championship when World Class Championship Wrestling returns to Texas Stadium. Texas Stadium, as the music plays for the entrance of Iceman King Carson's Buck Rock and Roll Zuma. Go for the American Tag Team title. There they come. Across the field and toward the ring. Being escorted in as General Akbar waits in the ring with his Super Destroyers, the current champion. There's the Iceman moving up the aisle. And here they are at the ring. Buck Rock and Roll Zoom off there with the big music box along with the Iceman. A bout they've been waiting for a long time for this big American tag team title. All right, it's 35,000 to gone. Here's Ralph Pulley.
This event, one fall, 60-minute time limit. This is for the American Tag Team title. First of all, on my right, the opponents, the combined weight of over 477 pounds. First of all, from Hawaii, Mr. Buck Rock and Roll Zumhoff. And his partner from St. Louis, Iceman King Parson. And the American Tag Team champions, representing Devastation Incorporated and General Akbar, with a combined weight of over 500 pounds, Super Destroyers 1 and 2. Fred Sinclair is your referee.
Okay, the American Tag Team title. The belts currently worn by the Super Destroyers as they remove them and hand them to the referee, Freddie Sinclair. Buck Rock and Roll Zumoff. An outstanding newcomer here to World Class Championship Wrestling, teaming with the always jive and Iceman King Parsons from St. Louis. General Akbar with plenty to say as Rock and Roll Zumoff tries to get this crowd fired up. What a mob.
Get that radio on.
Every time you look up, there are more people watching. There's the bell, and here we go. One fall, 20-minute time limit. Texas Stadium's Parade of Champions. Now Pulley corrects me on the time limit. One fall, 60. One fall, an hour. They're into the ropes. Zumoff thrown. The crisscross. Over. The arm drags by Zumoff. As the sun sets here this afternoon, part of the ring will be creeping into shadows. And I know our crew will work hard to keep the picture as it should be. That's sometimes a tough thing to do when half the playing field, or the ring in this case, is in shade, the other in sunshine. There's an arm twist by Zumoff. Clean tag. Iceman King Parsons in. There's the Iceman with a knee lift. Hard to tell these destroyers apart. This is Super D number one in the ring right now.
Come on, Iceman.
As I said earlier, this is the largest crowd ever to see professional wrestling in person.
Rip it off, Ice.
Iceman with that wrist lock. Destroyer now turns the table. The Iceman threatening fist. Iceman with a somersault drop kick, and away goes the Destroyer. The Iceman locks him up. We've got lots more to come even after this bout. The world television premiere of the Bad Street Video from the Freebirds, Michael Hayes. The six-man world title, as Fritz Von Erich will be here. The same ring, the same stadium where he retired. He will come back to team with his boys for this one time only. Nice man of the ropes. There's the drop kick, and look at the Destroyer. Iceman crawls across the Destroyer, backs out and runs out of ring and crawls right onto the floor. While the Iceman dances, the crowd cheers, and General Akbar somewhat upset. Let's look at this again. As you see the drop kick, now the Iceman will come charging across on his knees and back the Destroyer right to the floor. There's Akbar out there. He is somewhat perturbed with his Destroyers, it looks like. Akbar loves winners, only tolerates winners. Nice man with a headlock, but the Destroyer with a few knee lifts. And the Destroyer takes him to the turnbuckle. The Destroyer shows the Iceman that he'll have to find something else, but no! The Iceman gives him a headbutt anyway, and you saw what it did to the Super D. Akbar to the rescue there, as here's a tag. And again, it's Iceman versus Destroyer. Here's Zumoff in now. Full Nelson's him away from the corner. The Iceman will belt him. Zumoff climbs the turnbuckle and takes the Destroyer right back out to the center.
Man, what do you say? What
Here's a replay of that action. Look at Zumoff climb the turnbuckle, flip himself back out, and take the Destroyer down to the current position of in that side headlock. Zumoff to his knees.
Come on,
Tuski. Take that hole, Tuski. Come on, Buck. There's a clothesline attempt. Here's a sunset flip, I think. The Destroyer reaching forward, trying to keep his balance. He can't do it. Two, and the leg scissor are the only thing to save the big Super Destroyer, who at times I can't even tell apart. Again, Zumwalt climbs that corner buckling and flips the Destroyer back out, and this time the D grabs the hair. Akbar upset, the other Destroyer upset. This is Super D number two in the ring right now.
5 minutes.
5 minutes gone in this bout. As Ralph Pulley informs us. Boy, everyone involved in world-class championship wrestling, from the promoters to the television directors to the ticket takers, everyone just going above and beyond the call of duty to put this greatest ever card into Texas Stadium this afternoon. What an array of talent.
One, two, three.
Destroyer with a drive from the right. Zumwalt turns the tables back. What will happen? Here's a tag, the other D. Who's in, who's out? Zumwalt down. Super D number one stomping Zumwalt. Pulls him to the corner. Back, drop kick. He caught him in the chin and the chest. Here's a pin. American Tag Team title on the line. Up and over.
Let's go, Buck. Let's go.
There's a stomp from the rope. And listen to this crowd begin to make noise for Zumwalt. There's the other Destroyer. Zumwalt in the midst of the reverse chin lock by the Destroyer. Zumwalt comes to the ropes. Zumwalt nursing that face. Over the knee. Buddy Sinclair warning the Destroyers and reminding them to abide by the rules. Boy, last time we saw this American tag bout, we saw the flame at Reunion Arena. You'll remember that. Terrible happening. Zumwalt down, here's the Destroyer with a knee. This may be it. One, two, but no, Zumwalt hangs tough. Over the rope. Here's the Destroyer. Missing with a dropkick as Zumwalt held on. Here's the cartwheel in the corner, the Iceman in. Dropkick down goes the Destroyer. Iceman will handle both Destroyers. All 4 men involved now as Zumwalt is in to make it even. Zumwalt thrown to the ropes. Here's a sunset flip. Another sunset flip. Both men down. Could be. And that's just a count of two. Boy, I thought he had him. Here's Zumwalt thrown to the floor. It's 2-on-1 now. The Destroyer is going strong. 2-on-1. Akbar loving it from ringside. Zumwalt grabs the foot. The Iceman takes care of the other one. Could be, might be. There! The new champion. Iceman and Zumwalt are the new American Tag Team Champions. A wild finish. Let's go to Ralph Pulley.
The winners and new American Tag Team Champions, Buck Rock'n'Roll Zumwalt and Iceman King Parsons.
You heard it, the Destroyers don't believe it. When we come back, we'll have the Bad Street Video, then the six-man world title as world-class championship wrestling from Texas Stadium continues. As it will be a great card. Now then, it's time for the world television premiere of Bad Street USA.
country all stupid, but a place you don't want to be at. This ain't no home sweet home, it's a home sweet misery. We knew when we got here, they tried to put us away. But when they see us walk down the street, they ran the other way.
Back street in Atlanta, D.A. Back street in the whole U.S.A. Back street, nasty and hot.
The further down the block you went, the better it got. Jump in, she like to be a brow. Old lady McDuffie, she don't give the cops a call. She might as well call the Army or the United States Marines. Cause can't nobody handle this bad street scene.
Bad street, Atlanta, D.A. Bad street in the whole U.S.A. Bad street, nasty and hot.
The further down that block you went, the better it got. Don't think they were nasty, couldn't make it down in our block. But I'll never forget it, hearing that ambulance driver say, someone should have told them those boys about Bad Street USA. So don't you come looking on the side town, cause this is where the free birds live and everything's going down. If you don't know by now, we always get our way. That's the way it is down here on Bad Street USA.
Bad Street Atlanta, D.A. Bad street in the whole USA. Bad street, nasty and hot.
Further down that block, you ain't the battle it got.
World title, Bad Street Style. The Fabulous Freebirds on their way to the ring. Let's watch and listen. That goes to this Bad Street song. As Freebirds, Terry Gordy, and Buddy Roberts follow Hayes into the ring with the World Six-Man Trophy. And what a trophy it is. Three levels. Hayes is dancing to his music. And now the song changes. The fans begin to cheer. And here comes the monitor. This is Become As You Are, Bad Street Bout. Whatever you wear into the ring can be used. Notice the Freebirds in blue jeans. Gordy and Roberts with big leather belts with steel buckles. The boots. And here come the Von Erichs. Mike, Kevin, and Fitz, and look out, it's Broken Boots. Broken Boots already. They'll try to restrain the Freebirds and get Fritz, Kevin, and Mike back in the ring. This is an electrifying experience for all involved as Fritz Von Erich has returned to Texas Stadium where he retired for this one time only to team with his boys. And look at it, Fritz Handel Hayes. Fritz in his wrestling boots, jeans and shirt with a belt of his own, and Hayes thrown to the floor. Here's Gordy over the top rope. And bail out. Gordy with a chair. Chairs are flying here at Texas Stadium. Here's David Manning.
Well, does this work?
All right, listen up! Listen up! There's no rules in this match, but there's one rule we're gonna enforce. It's a tag team match. Only one of you comes in the ring, and that's the way it's gonna be. There'll be two people in the ring at once. No six man. And if you don't like it, you'll find yourself two against three. It's going to be one-on-one in the ring, and you can tag in and out. And that goes for the Von Erichs, too. You understand?
I was just standing in the ring.
David Manning reminding all parties concerned that there will be rules in this bout, and it is a tag team bout. One man at a time from each team. The World Six-Man Title. Next for the world title, most prestigious belt in all of the world. And it's even wilder today being a Bad Street Bout, meaning whatever you wear into the ring can be used. Boy, did Fritz ever handle Hayes a minute ago. Ronco Lipovich and David Manning, two referees here. Kevin Von Erich already bleeding from one of the chairs or something of that nature. And here we go. The bell is sounded. It's Roberts against Kevin. Oh, Roberts really hit hard in that corner. And Kevin, here's Hayes in now. This is going to be a tough bout to control. Kevin nails Gordy, who is over there in the wrong corner where he shouldn't be. Roberts, with both hands clenched, nails Kevin from behind. Kevin nursing that finger that's cut open. Drop kicks, or rather kicks Roberts out of the corner. Kevin wrestling barefooted. Fitz and Mike in boots. All of the Freebirds in Western-style boots with a pointed toe. What a thrill this is for Mike Von Erich, who's in the ring now to be able to team with his father, the legend. The greatest wrestler we've ever seen, Fritz Von Erich. Mike drops down on that leg and locks up the foot and toe. The largest crowd ever to see wrestling anywhere in the world is on hand here at Texas Stadium today, and I'm afraid to put a figure on it. But could be anywhere between 35 and 50,000. Look at Roberts hold Mike Von Erich down as Hayes stomps him across the face with those boots. How can anyone stand with punishment? There's a body slam. Hayes goes to the corner. Look out. Mike Von Erich out of the way. Here comes Fritz. The crowd leaps to its feet. They're standing at Texas Stadium. Thousand on their feet as Fritz Von Erich handles Michael Hayes. Right across, and Kevin is there. Fritz takes off his belt. Mike Von Erich holds Hayes. It's time to go to the woodshed. Look at Fritz. Woodshed City. Holy cow, look at Hayes run. Well, indescribable, absolutely indescribable. It's going to be a square off now between Kevin Von Erich and Freebird Terry Gordy. Texas Stadium's Parade of Champions here on World Class Championship Wrestling. I'm Mark Lawrence for Bill Mercer today. You're watching the World Six-Man Title Bad Street Style. The Fabulous Freebirds versus the Von Erichson. That means Fritz today for one time only. Kevin Von Erich with blood on his white trousers. There's a drive by Terry Gordy on Kevin Von Erich. Fritz not interested in officiating. Remember now, if the Von Erichs win this bout, Terry steps in to take Fritz's place. Here's Gordy. Kevin with a drive on Freebird Terry Gordy in the corner. A rough, tough bout. Flying Mayor Kevin out. He wants that iron claw that only the Von Erichs know. Gordy holds it off best he can.
5 minutes.
Ralph Pulley informing us there are 5 minutes gone in this bout. Here's Kevin to the ropes. Clothesline. Michael Hayes taking off the boot. Michael Hayes is taking off that boot and smashing it over the head. He can crack a head open with that boot. This is all legal. Remember, Terry steps in should the Von Erichs win to take Fritz's place. Here's Roberts hitting him over the head with that belt buckle as he throws his midsection forward, allowing that steel belt buckle to go into Kevin's head. Here comes Fritz, and look at Roberts. Fritz in the corner. The crowd again coming to its feet, but Hayes comes over. Gordy is there. It's mayhem. Fritz now, he wants another piece of Michael Hayes who's bleeding. Fritz Von Erich has the iron claw, Michael Hayes, and you are seeing it right here. The famous Fritz Von Erich iron claw is now on Roberts too. Can you believe it? The Von Erich iron claw. Now here's Gordy, and he's got his boot and is smashing it over Fritz's head. Doherty on Fritz, Hayes on Mike. Hayes is covered in blood. And Mike and Fritz throw the Freebirds right into each other, head first. Fritz Von Erich wants the Iron Claw again on Roberts. Mike with a boot on Terry Gordy. Again. No, look out, it's Mike Von Erich thrown into Roberts. Kevin with a splash from the corner. He was out on the floor. Hey, Von Erich's win. The Von Erichs have won the world's six-man title. And 50,000 fans go wild. Here comes the trophy. Here's Ralph Foley.
The new World Six-Man Tag Team Champions, the Von Erichs.
Hey, wait. What is this? What is this? Who is this? A huge, mean Oriental has rushed to the ring. I've never seen this before. The biggest Oriental I have ever laid eyes on has come to the ring with an Oriental spike. An Oriental spike on Kevin as Terry rushes to the ring. And this strange and deadly Oriental is against Fritz now in his corner. Mayhem has broken loose. I've never seen this person before. Who he is, where he's from, I cannot answer. But whoever he is, he came into this ring and used an Oriental spike on Kevin Von Erich. And whoever he is, he's now leading the Von Erichs in the ring victorious. Fritz, Mike, Kevin, and now Kerry with the World Six-Man title at Texas Stadium. We'll be back in just a moment. Mark Lawrence back with you, Texas Stadium, Irving, Texas, where it's time for the bout the world has been waiting for. The World Heavyweight Championship. And we'll start the music and await for the wrestlers to arrive here at the ring. Here comes Ric Flair. And a chorus of boos for him as he comes to the ring in the beautiful jacket, the blonde hair. Keep in mind, the largest crowd ever to see wrestling anywhere in the world is on hand here at Texas Stadium for this great card. In fact, the greatest the world has ever seen. A history-making event. Nature Boy Ric Flair, the World Heavyweight Champion from Minneapolis, Minnesota. So confident, so talented. One of the truly great world champions ever to step into the ring. There you see him as our cameras follow him to the ring. And he will step into the ring and will await the arrival of the challenger tonight, the heavy crowd favorite, Kerry Von Erich. Flair steps through the ropes and into the ring.
May not go to heaven. wrathfully.
This event is for the World Heavyweight title. There are two stipulations to this title. First of all, there is no time limit. And also, if the champion should disqualify himself, he will automatically be forced to relinquish his title and give it to Kerry Von Erich. First of all, the heavyweight champion of the world from Minneapolis, weighing 235 pounds, Mr. Ric Flair. And his challenger from Denton, Texas, weighing 259 pounds, Mr. Kerry Von Erich. Your referee is David Manning.
This is it. Make no mistake where you are. There are no seat belts on the chairs here at Texas Stadium, but we almost need them. The world has been waiting for this bout for months. Kerry Von Erich, as you see the world belt in front of you, Kerry Von Erich in probably the most beautiful ring jacket I've ever seen, which has the yellow rose and on the back says in memory of David Von Erich. He was here in honor of his brother, who no doubt would have been a world champion someday. Look at the looks on these two as David Manning tries to go over the rules. The intensity has never been higher. Flair with a parting word as he moves to his corner. There's the world belt held by David Manning. And here we go. No time limit. If Flair gets disqualified, he loses the belt. This is it. Here we go. The confidence on the face of Kerry Von Erich and the champion. We'll take just a moment to size this over again. 50,000 fans are here for this. This is what they've come to see. They're in the ropes, and the hold is broken. There is only one world heavyweight champion. He represents the entire world. Flair takes him down, can't find the handle, carry up and ready. This crowd, you can feel the tension amongst this mob. They will reserve their enthusiasm. Spoken too soon because the roar begins to come. The chant, go, Kerry, go. They've brought signs. They've brought their voices. Flair can't find the handle. The favorite is always the champion in a bout like this. He has the experience, he's defended the belt so many times before against so many. But in light of the circumstances that have put Kerry in this ring today, so many, many favor Kerry. World Class Championship Wrestling bringing this all to you. What a great show it's been, what a great show last week. Down goes Flair. Kerry to the ropes. Leapfrog with the champion. Kerry turns, shot kick, down goes Flair. Kerry's there again. And the champion cows in the corner. Remember on our show last week, we heard Heaven Needed a Champion by the lovely Phil Floyd. If you would like a copy of that, send your donation to the David Von Erich Memorial Gymnasium at the Temple Christian Academy, Temple Baptist Church, Louisville, Texas. Your donation goes to the building of that magnificent facility, and your name will go on an ornamental plaque at the entrance of that new facility. And you can have a copy of that beautiful song of your own. Referee stance turns into a side headlock by Kerry Von Erich. The champion pushes him up and off. Kerry with that tremendous physique. Look at the muscles in those arms. Even as he is bent down, and now the thing begins to go the other way as Flair is taken down. The Von Erich dream is underway.
Oh.
Eric name has been meant so much to professional wrestling, all of sports, all of society. As their example inside the ring and outside the ring in the real world has meant so much to so many. Here's the champion charging into Kerry with a shoulder, who's in the corner. Slapping Kerry, and the fans can hear it all through the stadium. Kerry is rolling now. Flair. Back to his feet. There's a drive by Kerry. Kerry has him high. Power slam, and down goes the champion. The Nature Boy. We've seen him before. We heard what he had to say in advance weeks, previous weeks, coming into this via taped interview. And now we're seeing the bout. Flair out on the floor. The count has begun. David Manning with the count. And Flair back in before it even gets close. A beautiful, warm afternoon at Texas Stadium. The largest crowd ever. As Ric Flair, perhaps, in fact, without a doubt, his toughest test ever in defending the World Heavyweight Championship, and he's defending it a few times. Flair has so much. The mind, the body, it all has to work together. And Kerry Von Erich reaching that same level. Kerry has worked so hard. He's been on world tour in recent weeks. Kerry on his knees. There's that shot by the champion, Kerry, into the ropes. The champion has gained momentum, and Kerry goes to the floor. Kerry right back like nothing ever happened, but Flair is waiting for him. Kerry with a headbutt from the apron. Kerry over Sunset Flip. But Flair reaches for the rope. Will he go down? Yes. One, two, and the leg scissors. You could see it coming. Oh, the level of intensity is so high in this bout and amongst this crowd. They leap to their feet with every pin count. Kerry wants to put him out. The sleeper. Both men slow to get back to their feet. Here's a flying mare by the champion, Kerry down. The champion backs away to the far rope. And it's a knee across the head. Kerry Von Erich on his knees. The champion wants David Manning out of the way. A thrill for David Manning to get to officiate this world title bout. Here's the suplex, and down goes Kerry. The champion will have his first pin of this bout. Two, look out. Oh. Drop kick by Kerry. Flair was not expecting that. And Flair moves right back over with an elbow. This? Who's going to get in the abdominal stretch? It's Kerry stretching out the champion, Ric Flair. Abdominal stretch, and we're in position for a possible submission. But in a world title situation, I'm not sure you'd ever see it.
What's the tights?
Flair yelling about the tights. Tosses Kerry over. What great camera work and great audio. Here's Kerry back on his feet. A knee across the champion's head. It's Carey. Flair with the tights gets a knee in the midsection. And goes Carey. Flair to the rope.
And it's a iron claw. Carey Von Erich with that patented, unique Von Erich iron claw. No one else can do it like the Von Erichs, and Flair is paralyzed. Look at this crowd. Listen to them.
David Manning warning Flair about that blow which he just delivered to Carey Von Erich. Both men on their knees. It's hot in that ring out there. And this is the toughest bout probably either of these men will ever be in. Look out. The champion climbing. Carey's on his feet. Grabs him. Takes him out and throws him across Texas Stadium. Carey with a drive, the champion in the corner. Flair upside down, falling back. Good grief, Charlie Brown. Carey with a right. Step over toe hold, but Carey puts a stop to that by kicking the champion away. Another step over attempt, and Carey knocks him away a second time. Here's Flair from the ropes, wants to toss Carey across. Carey's got him. Here's the Nelson pin. Go! Carey! The dream comes true! Yes!
The new heavyweight world heavyweight champion, Carey Von Erich.
The wrestlers pouring out of the locker room. 50,000 fans standing and roaring. Flair doesn't know what happened to him. The day has come. The dream has come true. Let's watch this celebration.
I'll be back. They're going to be in trouble. I'll be back. You tell your brothers, you tell your old man, Ric Flair, I'll be back.
You got it, baby. You got it, Chad.
Let's go back and see the World Heavyweight Championship victory again. You see Flair to the ropes, came back. Each man tried to toss the other. A couple of hooks, finally Carey with a full Nelson, takes him over, no room for the leg scissors here. And three, the dream came true. And look at the fans leap to their feet. There's the little bell. The yellow rose in honor of Brother David, who I know has a smile on his face at this very moment. What a thrill. Carey Von Erich, the new world heavyweight champion, with the Texas flag, the big yellow rose, and the heavyweight belt. There's Carey.
Ladies and gentlemen, once again, the new world heavyweight champion, Carey Von Erich.
says he wants to go back for one more time, and can you blame him? The Texas flag unveiled in the ring. And the world bell wrapped in that Texas flag. Harry's got it all. Well, there he goes, the new world heavyweight champion, Kerry Von Erich. I'm Mark Lawrence at Texas Stadium as we see Kerry fighting his way through the mobs and heading for the back, and there's Fritz. You can see Fritz Von Erich in the background. Fritz there to greet Kerry. There's Mrs. Von Erich, Kerry's mother. The handshakes. And you're right there to see it all. What a day this is. The new heavyweight champion of the world, the dream has come true. I'm Mark Lawrence. We're not through yet. Mark Lawrence here in the ring at Texas Stadium, where Kerry Von Erich has become the new world heavyweight champion. Yes, that's right. What a day it's been. A record-breaking crowd, a record-breaking card, and a record-breaking show for you to enjoy. I know you enjoyed it. I'm Mark Lawrence for Bill Mercer. Until next time, so long, everybody.